Before diving into the basics of creating toolpaths and NC code in SolidWorks CAM, I want to highlight a few new interfaces that will guide our workflow. First, I'll enable the SolidWorks CAM add-in by clicking the gear icon, selecting add-ins, checking SolidWorks CAM, and pressing OK. Once the add-in loads, three new tabs will appear in the manager tree on the left, and a SolidWorks CAM tab will be added to the command manager. To start milling in SolidWorks CAM, I'll first define the machine settings that will be used to mill this part. I'll navigate to the SolidWorks CAM Feature Tree tab. This tab is essential for defining the machine and selecting the stock that will be used in the machining process. Additionally, we'll use this tab to adjust parameters for each feature within the part. By default, a machine named Mill Inch is selected for milling. This icon in the tree allows us to configure the machine, define tools, and set the post-processor. I can right-click to choose Edit Definition, or simply double-click the machine node to open it. Within the machine dialog box, I'll navigate each tab from left to right to fully define the setup. On the Machine tab, there's a list of available mill and turn machines, with properties displayed for the highlighted machine, while details for the selected active machine appear below. These properties are drawn from a technology database, which I'll demonstrate how to modify later. For now, I'll set Mill Inch as the active machine by selecting it. Moving to the Tool Crib tab, I can select a tool crib, which defines the set of tools available for our machine. Note that this is a subset of tools from the technology database, representing the actual tools available in the facility. You can update the tool crib by adding, removing, or editing tools as needed. By clicking Add Tool, I can access the Tool Selection dialog box. Since the database includes thousands of tools, filters help narrow down the selection. I'll set the tool type to drill and filter diameter between 0 and 2 inch. After selecting a tool, I'll click OK to add it to the tool crib list, where I can further edit its parameters to precisely match the tool in use. Any changes in this tool crib will apply only to this part, meaning these customizations will be saved with the part file, not globally in the database. I'll show later how to make global updates in the technology database to apply to all parts. Next, I'll switch to the post-processor tab. The post-processor formats the NC or G-code output, and SolidWorks CAM offers several built-in options. If needed, I can enter the file path directly or use the Browse button to locate it. For this lesson, I'll choose a post-processor, displaying its parameters and description below. The Posting tab also provides options to customize specific information that will appear on the setup sheet, such as coolant and tool offset values, which can be defined in either the post-processor or the tool. Since we're working with a 2.5-axis milled part in this section, the setup, rotary axis, and tilt axis tabs aren't applicable. To proceed, I'll click OK to confirm the machine selections and move on to defining the stock for this part.